to him too. And that's what you see building. So we'll see. It's gonna be a good one by the time I fight. But when that fight happens, and we go from there. I'm looking forward to it.
Deontay, when going into a fight with Jennings and Klitschko, Jennings shot to win. Looks like next up from is Tyson Fury. Do you give Tyson any shot to it, or at least a better shot than Jennings would have had to win?
Yep. I want to address that fight with Jennings. My thoughts definitely was with Klitschko, as far as him winning and stuff like that, due to Jennings' experience with taller fighters and stuff like that. Even though my thoughts were with Klitschko, my heart was with Jennings, because I wanted Jennings, you know, my heart was with Jennings because he was a fellow American citizen as well, and I wanted the remaining adults to be with another. It would have been awesome to have another American champion, you know, address that. But with Tyson Fury, I think he got a hell of a chance of winning. But I think it's going to be up to Tyson Fury how he dedicates himself to this boxing, how serious he is about it, because many times he's about the money instead of the glory of different things. So it's going to depend on how serious he takes this fight, you know. But I feel you see many times where Tyson have got knocked down by the smaller guys as well too, and if Klitschko hit him, the question is, will he get up as he got up from the smaller guys?
Well, he seems to have like two different fighting styles. He either comes in like he did, which is in the Chisora rematch, he just boxes, stays behind the jab, or he comes in there like he did with Steve Cunningham when he got dropped, and he just gets reckless and clowns around.
You're right.
And it seems the way to fight Vladimir, he's not going to probably outbox him. He's going to have to rough him up.
That's what he definitely is going to have to do. He's going to have to do that. With the Chisora fight, he wasn't worried. You can tell in the first couple of rounds that what type of fight it would have been, you know. So when as a fighter, you can sense what type of fight is going to be, the motion of the fight, when you get in there, just the momentum of it, what it's going to be. And he knew that it was a kid at the playground in a couple of rounds, so that he was able to do whatever he wanted to do. With the Cunningham, he knew it was a more serious, especially when he got dropped. He started doing illegal stuff, trying to rough him up and stuff like that. And with Klitschko, I agree with you. He's going to have to come out and try to rough him, but he's going to have to be a smart one, though, not get caught, though. That's the thing about the taller fighters. You make a mistake, you can get punished.
Well, he's, I think, a couple inches taller than Vladimir, actually.
Definitely.
And I noticed even in the Pulev fight, Pulev came out swinging and actually rattled Vladimir a few times, but he left himself also wide open for a counter.
Definitely. So it all depends on who has the best strategy in that fight, who's the smarter guy. You know, I like fighting taller guys, as well, as because it's more competitive to me. You know, because I know that if I make a mistake, I can't get punished if he recognizes that mistake and he apply pressure to that mistake. But we'll see with Fury and stuff like that, with the Klitschko. Klitschko's getting older, like I said before, and like I said in this fight, it definitely shows. So yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing that fight, and I'm looking forward to seeing that fight and taking the winner of it.
What do you think of the other guy that's coming up? It seems that you and him pegged as the two guys who are the future of the division, which is Anthony Joshua from the UK.
Yep, I feel he's still got a lot of growing to do. You know, being in the UK, them are massive fans. I love the UK because they boxing is like their second nature as well. So anybody that look like a potential, they're gonna automatically hype them up. You know, they did the same thing to David Price, and look what happened to him. So I've told them guys years ago, you know, just let them build. You know, maybe a year ago, let them build. Let them, you know, it's good to have somebody with potential that look like can bring excitement, but let them grow. You know, and so I think he's gonna do good in the division. As long as he stay focused, as long as he dedicates himself to the sport, he shouldn't have no problem adjusting to a lot of things as he's on his way up. You know, hopefully that the back injury don't cause a problem, you know, as he start experiencing other fighters and stuff like that. Because, you know, when we have surgery on something, it's never the same. And I done had said, look at my hands, it's beat up. And it's never the same. I feel old sometimes because my joints hurt and stuff, and I'm only 29 years old.
How do you have your little back and forth back in New York? Have you taken security precautions to make sure Shannon doesn't start following?
Nah, we're not worried about Shannon. We're not worried about Shannon. Shannon is a showman, man. He's just like to entertain this right here, the cameras. You know, many times I met Shannon when back in LA when the Ariola was fighting Stavern, and I told Shannon I'm not that type of person to be playing around with or whatever. And he acknowledged that. He said, he said, I respect you, you know, and he told me that, you know, I just do it to entertain the people and stuff like that. So I know Shannon, you know, he's trying to come back. He's old, he's like 42, still trying to entertain the people. He's so desperate for attention because he wanted back. He don't want to do it the regular way, fight his way up. He's trying to talk his way in. And it's not going to work because I tell people at the point of time, I say if it works, then you'll be the smartest man around. But if it don't work, you look like a clown. And right now he's looking like Dodo the Clown with the big red nose. And people are not laughing with him, they're laughing at him. And he can't distinguish the two. He just thinking entertainment. And enough is enough, man. No grown man should be chasing another grown man around. You know, anything, you should be chasing the women, man. You don't be chasing another grown man, messing with his food and going on the beach and stuff like that. And just all that, man, that's got you.
What would your reaction be if you were like bodyboarding on the lake and you saw Shannon coming up behind in a boat?
I'll, you know, being my personality, man, I'm silly anyway, man. I'll consider that as comedy, man. I'll laugh.
Think that might be scripted though? Seems like a lot of it is a little bit too good for
it. Look like it, don't it? Because when you look at the dinner scene, he could have got at him if he really wanted to.
And all those cameras at the right time, the right place.
But I heard somebody was sponsoring him to do stuff, like helping him like travel. Like, why is he everywhere? Like, I heard somebody was like investing in them to do different little things. Because just be honest, if I want to get you, I'm gonna get to you. Yeah. I'm not just gonna throw no plate or when somebody throw water on my face and dramatically fall and act like I couldn't get to you because I failed. And then he got a little small glass cut in his foot and he had to go to the emergency. Oh, man, if I'm gonna get you, glass in my foot or not, I'm gonna get you.
Do you think Shannon could win a fight to actually earn a shot at somebody in the division?
It's possible.
Or is it just all show?
I mean, it's possible, you know what I mean? But I don't think he'll pass the drug test, you know, to even get a shot. He's so shot up on steroids, man. He's so, you know, and I seen this guy in Atlanta. He had to fight out there and come back and see him maybe 6 months later. He was like just puny and come back and see my veins all out of his shoulder. I'm in the best shape of my life, I bet you is.
And he loves showing that off,
man. Yeah, he loves every time he come over because he's on that juice. He got tested positive one time before. I fought him out of my gym. I fought him out of our gym and got tested. So he's back on that juice. He need to let it loose.
Yeah. So what are some of the names you thinking of as far as your next fight?
As far as my next fight, you know, we got a lot of good names, man. I don't wanna spoil it.
Okay.
We're making an announcement next week. We're supposed
this
to
year, 4th of July, fun on a Saturday. Wouldn't that have been a good day for you, being the American heavyweight champion, to have fought on 4th of July?
Man, I would have had them colorful red, white, and blue flag trunks like Apollo 3. Man, that would have been nice, though, man. You know, I look at the exciting part about it, you know, 4th of July, and what the meaning behind it and stuff like that.
Right.
That would be a exciting fight. It's just like May 5th, Cinco de Mayo in Florida. I always like to have and fight a Mexican guy. Well, I think that's a great idea.
Which Mayweather just completely took over.
Yeah, definitely.
It's holiday.
Just an idea. I mean, when you come up with an idea, you just take it and you run with it, you know?
What do you think of this whole Cinco de Mayo, Mayweather-Pacquiao weekend? What do you make of it? How do you see the crowds and
this is the most intensive, more exciting, you know, crowd I ever seen here, man. I'm talking about that's even before. Like, most of the time when I come here Thursday, be okay, mellow.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But as the fight get closer, people start going, but they was here like time.
Tuesday, no?
Dog, they was in the airport. Like, when I got in the airport, I was, you know, dealing with fans and media and TMZ in my face and stuff like that. I'm like, man, so when I got on the strip, even last night, I'm like, wow, like, this is crazy. And every whore from all over the world is here in town.
How are you able to get around with all the people here then?
I'm a people's person, man. You know, that's why I had the bad guys to take my part. If it was up to me, I'll take pictures with everybody around. You know, that's just my personality. I never meet strangers. That's the saying goes. You know, that's just me, man. I'm a champion, but not only that, I'm a people's champion as well, and I love the people. You know, I'll kiss every baby there is out there, sign autographs, take pictures. If it was up to me, when I won my belt, I came to Vegas. I was in the lobby for 4 hours just because I wanted to, just with the people.
After
the fight, I was still there, and somebody acknowledged that. They were like, man, we love you for that. We appreciate you.
And with your height, you really can't get away anyway.
You can't get away anyway, man. I tried that before because I had to get somewhere. I tried to duck in. I tried to. Somebody knows you. You know, and then when you come in, especially when you bring the kids, don't be bringing them kids up, man. You know, I love the kids. And time you stop, that's when it's, you know, which is all good to me. It's hilarious to see the guys that are around me or security try to bag the people up. I thought that's so comfortable because they moving, everybody moving, people ain't listening. They still trying to get to you. This only thing about this different from any time I've been here, the people are aggressive, man. They are, the women and men are aggressive. If they want pictures, they finna get the pictures. They finna hit everybody. Like, the women's are very aggressive too. They touching me and stuff like that. I'm like, ooh, I laugh.
So what do you make of the fight this weekend though? What's your prediction for it?
Oh man, do I have to say it again?
Yeah.
Well,
you're probably gonna have to say it a couple more times too.
Thank you, brother. My opinion is, I think Florida definitely win this fight. A smart Florida was gonna win this fight. I think Floyd got the best defense in the business of boxing. Okay. And I definitely think he's got his ability to adapt to fighters is pretty cool to me. You know, as the rounds he fights with a chest. And when we see the Madonna fight, Madonna had the remedy of beating him with that shoulder roll and with it coming over the top. He had it.
Right.
But Floyd was able to adjust to it, see it. And it took him a minute because nobody really had that remedy. Anybody want to be Floyd, they go back and look at that Madonna fight and study that fight and how to come at the right time or hit him. But he adjusts and he won. Even the second one made it easier because he was able to adjust. He already knew.
So how do you beat a guy who can always make adjustments to what you're doing? You have to make adjustments.
You got to adjust too. Okay. It's a game. Right. Like I said, this fight is going to be a high expert chess game.
Okay.
Whoever make the right move is going to win. And I do feel that this is boxing. Anything can happen in boxing. But I feel that if this fight is a good close fight, for some reason I feel like they're going to get it to Maddie because it's more money in a rematch or a draw if it's a good one.
Let me ask you this then. If Mayweather wins, is he TBE in your opinion?
I mean,
where would you put him?
Who's there that be left? This is the most anticipated bout in years. Everybody wanted to see for 5 years has been, you know, this is the main one that people have been like, who? When you look in the division, who else?
Yeah.
Who else? But you know what? After seeing Amir Khan, his last couple of fights, he looked super fast, dog. I wouldn't mind, you know, I wouldn't mind seeing that, man.
He be the best ever?
Would he be
Sugar Ray Robinson, Muhammad Ali? You know,
I think he'd be the best ever in his weight division.
Okay.
I wouldn't go in other weight divisions. I think that's a little bit too much.
Okay.
But I think he'd be the best in his weight division. I stick with that.
Okay. Yeah, Deontay, June 13th in Alabama, your next fight. How does that feel to have your first title defense in your backyard?
I mean, it feels great considering that we had a lot of other champions that have came from Alabama, but people don't even know, like Evander Holyfield, Joe Lewis, Ernie Shavers. And me being able to have an opportunity to still reside there and still build and become a champion there, it's an awesome feeling alone. But to be able to bring a commission back there, to be able to have professional fights, that's another feeling alone was great for me. But now, here I am, furthermore, a year or so later, years later, being able to bring Alabama their first ever title fight in history, you know, heavyweight title fight in history, it's an amazing feeling. It just let me know that if I keep setting my goals and I keep applying pressure to it to reach it, but anyway, any goal that I've set in my life, though, when I found out that I could set a goal and it can actually come through hard work, and if I apply the right principles and goals to that to accomplish that goal, when I accomplished my first goal, it was a great feeling in the world. And that first goal was like to make A's and B's in school or whatever, because so when I set goals, man, I get there because I know nothing's ever been given to me. I know through hard work getting there. So when I set the goals, that's for the state of Alabama. They have a world, they have a way to have a world from Alabama. And I'm setting that state. I'm building. It's been about football for so long, but they say now, Deontay Wilder's number one, Alabama football number two, because football is only nationwide, you know, and boxing is worldwide. So it's a great feeling to be able to fight back in Alabama and have a title fight there. I want to move to the BJCC. The BJCC actually is bigger than the MGM Grand when you're holding people. So I can have my own Vegas in Alabama. That's my next plan.
And like you mentioned about football, like just like Terrence Crawford, Nebraska, another football area, and gets 10,000-11,000 people.
Definitely.
I would think this seems like the community really rallies around the fighters when there's not any pro teams, especially like what you're talking about.
Definitely, because it's a worldwide event. It's nothing like boxing. It's nothing like a worldwide event. You know, especially when you're in a state that's all about college football. But then when you bring something else, it's far as the world, now the world gravitates to one place. Now the world it all comes in one place. You have not only just the locals, but just the people in the state, but you have people all over the world, whether that's across seas or from another state and stuff like that. And that's the beauty part about having a world champion is that. And then you bring in revenue to the cities, money and stuff like that. And every politician love that. Governors, and they love the money to come to this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh man, the governor is super happy that I'm bringing. So, and I'm happy to be able to put my name on it and say I'm the first to do that. So, you know, when boxing is over for me, my children, my loved ones, and all people walks of life could remember the things I've done as the heavyweight champion of the world. And the doors are open. The doors are closed to allow other doors to open. You know, I want to be remembered as somebody that done great things, that brought heavyweight boxing back to its all-time high of excitement. There's a lot of people that haven't even paid attention to boxing in years until they read about my story, until they saw the excitement of Deontay Wilder, and they said, I haven't kept up with boxing ever in my life, but when I watched your fight, I'm a fan. And that does my heart warm, because I'm like, yo, that's a life-changing thing right there, you know, for somebody that never kept up with it, but then now, reading my story or just seeing the fight, they're a fan, or they like watching boxing. It's just like my mother, man. My mom all the time watching boxing. I'm like, you know, I go over her house and she come on my house, it's boxing. She know about these fighters and stuff like that. It was amazing to me that she can tell me about fighters and stuff like that. For a woman, she's like, oh, mommy, almost 60 maybe. You know, but she love all these fighters. I think her favorite fighter is like Keith Thurman, though, and
not you?
And Keith, of course, I'm always be number one. But she love Keith Thurman and Key and Chocolate. She love Peter Quilty.
I told Michelle.